Myself PV Ekhande, working as assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand of Technology Solapur. Today we are going to observe the problems related to the planes in which strike and dip of the plane is given and where to complete the projections. At the end of this session, students will be able to complete the projections of the plane when the strike and dip of the plane is given, dip direction is given, and now the problem which we have taken is related to the strike and dip completion of the projection when the front view of the plane is given and in the top view one of the point is given. So question is like this: draw top view of the triangle PQR having strike south 50 degrees west and dips 45 degrees with the direction south easterly. So dip direction is south easterly. For this, the figure given is front view of the plane PQR is given, top view for that PH point is given. Now the first step is to complete the strike line in the top view. As we know that strike line is nothing but the true length line from the plane, which is a horizontal line, the line which is parallel to ground plane or parallel to HRP, and that line is called as a horizontal line. That will show the true length in the top view, which is called as a strike line of the plane. Now for the strike line of the plane, strike of the plane is given as a south 50 degrees west and the point given is P. So this strike is with respect to P corner of the plane PQR. Now with respect to this P point, first we have to complete this angle 50 degrees in the direction south towards west, means in the third quadrant we have to complete this line with respect to P at the inclination 50 degrees. Remember that strike line which is to be completed should have the angle with respect to vertical line, that is from south towards west. This angle should be 50 degrees. So the angle with respect to vertical line south towards west, that is 50 degrees. And to obtain the edge view of the plane, we know that we have to take the plane perpendicular to strike line. So this line is a strike line of the plane, which we can write that as a SL as a short form for that. And dip angle which is given, that is with respect to ground plane, which we are going to observe on the auxiliary front view side, which will make the angle with respect to ground or HRP, and that angle is 45 degrees, but the direction given, that is also important. Now the direction is south towards east, or that is written as a south easterly. Now we have to complete the dip direction line in the plan as a line perpendicular to strike line. Now this is a strike line which we have completed at 50 degrees angle. Dip direction given is south easterly, means from south towards east we have to complete the perpendicular line from the P point or any location on the strike line which is completed over there. Now for example, for instance, we'll take the line perpendicular to strike line with respect to P. So this is dip direction in which the plane should have the downward inclination, and for that purpose we'll see how to complete the edge view of the plane first. Now edge view, that is to be completed as a line perpendicular to the strike line. So this line will complete with respect to this strike line, which is a line perpendicular to the true length line for obtaining the edge view of the plane. So this line, which is a reference line taken according to the auxiliary plane's instruction with in the intersection with the horizontal plane, so we'll write this auxiliary plane as a auxiliary reference line as a H1, which is nothing but the intersection of HRP and auxiliary plane number 1. Now on this side we'll obtain the edge view of the plane. For that purpose we'll take the plane corner distances from this side, means we are going to transfer the distance from this side on this side, means opposite to H will have the transferring of the distance opposite to H on this side. So this is HRP, this is also HRP, or this can be considered as a ground plane, which is nothing but the parallelity with HRP. And distances are marked for Q point, R point, those are to be taken from this side and which are to be marked on this side on the respective projector, or the locus is to be obtained at that point on this auxiliary plane side. Now first point, P point, which we are going to transfer on this side on the projector of PH. So the distance for this PF point, which is a 22 millimeter from the HRP, we can take the distance in compass, we can transfer this on this side, or we can have the marking of the distance with respect to scale. So this point is a P1 point, which is projection of corner P, that's why we are writing as a P1, as it is on the auxiliary plane number 1. Now to obtain the dip line or the edge view of the plane, dip angle is given, which is 45 degrees, which is to be drawn with respect to horizontal line, means a line parallel to HRP. If the line is parallel to HRP on this side, this will have the parallelity on this side in this way. So it will have the parallelity with respect to HRP. This is also a parallelity with respect to HRP. So with respect to this parallel line, we are going to complete the angle 45 degrees, which is the angle for the HUO with respect to HRP or with respect to ground plane. Now 45 degrees angle is here, so that's why if we complete the angle with respect to this, that will have the 45, and 45 will be there. But remember that the angle for the dip direction is always to be taken with respect to this horizontal line. So measurement of the angle should be from this side on this rotation side. Now for decision to have the inclination, whether to have the inclination on this side with respect to this, or it should have the inclination in the opposite direction. For that purpose, dip direction is important, that is the southeasterly, which we have completed over here, south towards east. Now on this side, the plane should have the downward inclination. What is mean by downward inclination? It is nothing but the angle of the plane which we are going to observe by standing on the ground. If the man is standing on the ground on this side, front view side, the position will be like this, means head is on the top view side, top side, head and foot are on this side. The transferring of this man over here will be like this, means man will have the position on this HRP auxiliary view side will be like this. Now when the man will observe its inclination, it should be in the dip direction side, means it should have the inclination towards this side, means angle which is to be completed, line is to be completed, should be like this, not should be like this. So this is the correct way. Now the 45 degrees angle that is to be taken with respect to this. So 45 degrees angle when we are going to mark with the protractor. So 45 degrees angle we are going to complete with respect to horizontal side, horizontal line, which will have the inclination on this side with respect to this as a 45 degrees. Now on this side P1 point is obtained. To obtain the Q point or the R point, now we have to transfer the distances for obtaining the locus of this. Now for Q point, the point is located at 8 millimeter distance. So in the compass, you have to take the 8 millimeter distance and first locate that point on this vertical line for obtaining the locus of that, which is a line parallel to ground. So this is a line parallel to ground, which is nothing but the locus of Q point, and the intersection will be obtained as a Q1. Now third corner, that is the R corner, this R corner is to be obtained by transferring this distance on this side, and the distance for this R is 40 8 millimeter. So this 48 millimeter distance you have to take in compass and first mark that point on this side and draw the locus through this point as a line parallel to this. So this line is a locus of, so this is a locus of R point and it will have the intersection over here. So this point is a R1 point. Now the edge view of the plane is from Q towards R like this. So this much length is edge view of the plane and this edge view, from this we have to take the back projection for obtaining the points in the top view or the plan. So we'll have the projection in the backward direction from Q and R point. So P point were taken from PH towards P1. Now R point and Q were to take in the backward direction means we have to draw the projector of this Q point in the backward direction, projector of this R point in the backward direction. So this backward direction projector will have the intersection with the projector drawn from QF and RF. So on these projectors which is taken from the front view will have the intersection. So R1 intersection with this projector is to be indicated as RH. Q1 back projection, its intersection with the projector from QF, that is to be indicated as a QH. And after connecting these three corners, that is PQR, we are getting the plan or the top view of the plane. So this is a completion of top view. So this PH, QH, RH is top view of the plane, which is answer for this question. Have you understood how to complete the plane's top view when the front view is given? So for this we have referred the problems from the book of Engineering Graphics by Professor Deshpande, Mahalakshmi Publications. Thank you.